Transferring photos onto a project is actually not as hard as it looks, but what blows my mind is one of the most popular ways that you see on YouTube is not really a way you can do it, because the way that you keep seeing a lot of people do it is they're printing with a laser printer, which uses toner, and then you flip the page over and then you apply some heat to it or some glue and it pulls the toner from the paper of whatever paper you're using onto your project. Well, the problem is you're like, step one, okay, I'm super excited about this, looks really cool. And then step two, you're like, laser printer. Where do I find a laser printer? Nobody has a laser printer at home. Laser printers are crazy expensive. And I mean, you can find one at like Kinko's or the UPS store or something, but you're not gonna have a laser printer. So let me show you how to do this with an inkjet printer. Pulling this off with an inkjet printer is actually really easy because there's a trick. All you need to do is print your image on something that's very, very thin. And then once you have it there, then you can cover it up with a clear coat and there's no seam. So what do I use? I use tracing paper. Tracing paper works really well for this trick because what it does is, first of all, it's really thin. It still accepts the ink from your inkjet printer. And then it also, once the clear enamel hits it, it soaks into it and pulls it up against your project. So it's really cool. So let's get started. Okay, so we've got our images that we've cut out. Now, some had a border, and if you leave a big border on your images, they look great when you do this trick. Some of them didn't have a border, and the reason I did this is to specifically show you, you don't necessarily need a border for this trick to still look good. Some didn't have a border, but we kind of created one just by the way we cut it out, just like these two American flags. I wanted to show you straight up what a photo looks like during this trick. It looks really, really good. And then my other photo, I took the background out of. The color of material that you use for this trick makes a huge difference. So if I put a picture on a light background, it brightens up the picture a lot. If I take a picture and I put it on a dark background, obviously it darkens it up a little bit. And of course, we're going to use wood too, because that's a great substrate for this. And wood is really natural. It's a natural color, kind of a mid-tone. And what happens is with photos, it ends up looking really good behind your tracing paper. Now that my images are ready to go, I'm just going to put a really, really light coat of very, very lightweight spray adhesive on the back so they sit real flush on my project. I'm going to start with my photo, since that seems to be the most popular that I've seen people really want to learn how to do, is transfer photos onto wood. Remember, don't go hog wild with the spray adhesive, and you want to get it as flush as possible onto your wood. Make sure there's absolutely no bubbles or anything underneath there. And obviously, what's cool about this inkjet ink on top of tracing paper is it doesn't really run once it's dry. So you can get down there and you can press it down without having to worry about your image getting messed up. Okay, now the magic happens. All you're gonna do is put your clear coat on now. But remember, spray can clear is a nightmare. So you're gonna have to start with a very, very light coat, the first coat. That'll tack everything down and it'll soak into your tissue paper, your tracing paper, and it'll make your images look really good. Then, once that tacks up just a little bit, then start putting some other coats. And make sure to watch your coating time so you don't get any weird effects. Now understand, if you are doing a really important project, then just use two-part clear. You use two-part clear in with this effect and it works amazing the first time, and you can just gob it on because two-part clear doesn't have any problems like that. So let's keep our fingers crossed. Really, really light coat in the first coat. It should soak through, and then we'll put about three or four more coats on top of that to really get that image to soak up against our project. One more thing is so cool about this. You'll notice as soon as you hit this with your enamel clear, as it soaks into the tissue paper, it darkens everything up and it really soaks it down into your project. Now, let's check out this American flag. It's kind of torn up, it's kind of ragged on the edges. But what's really cool is it still works really well because since the tissue paper is so lightweight, it'll just soak everything down into the wood. So let's check out what we got. As you can see, our like ragged American flag turned out really good. It's stuck way up against our project. There's almost no seam whatsoever, which is really cool. Smaller objects like this work amazing. I can hardly even tell that there's a seam or anything on the outside of this. Now, my photo that I cut the background out of, it looks really, really good. Not much of a seam at all. As you see though, as I get to my bigger picture, I can start to see a seam just because it's such a large object that you tend to have trouble with the edges. But if I really wanted this to look good, if I covered it up with a really thick clear coat, you wouldn't notice at all and it would be perfect. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you've got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommanderDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.